Now student, we are going to discuss question number 7.6, and in this question it is given to you, obtain the resonant frequency omega r of series LCR circuit, clear? And it is given L value, C value and R value. Now what is value of Q, value of this circuit, clear? So first of all, let's draw here this LCR, series LCR circuit. I can say, let's suppose this is inductor L, here we have capacitor, and I can say here we have resistance R, clear? Values are also given to you, this is twice Henry, I can say C equal to 32 microfarad, clear? Value of R, this is given to you 10 ohm, clear? It is connected with an AC source, clear? So let's suppose it is connected with an AC source, clear? Now we have to find resonant frequency. First of all, let us try to understand what is resonant frequency. Resonant frequency you will find when frequency of this circuit is equal to natural frequency, clear? So it means I can say for resonant frequency, what is condition? Resonant frequency. Actually, what is meaning of resonant frequency? Resonant frequency means we can say we are getting here maximum value of current, clear? So if we talk about IRMS, this is written like this, VRMS divided by Z, clear? And for an LCR circuit, you can say value of Z, this is given by under root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square, clear? Now, if you draw here phasor diagram, you can say, let's suppose I am saying this is impedance triangle, clear? Let's suppose this is representing R, clear? In this direction, we have XL, clear? In this direction, we have XC. I am assuming here that XL is greater than XC, so at that time you can say net value you will get here in this direction, that is XL minus XC, clear? And definitely you will get resultant in this direction, and actually this is value of Z, clear? So you can get here value Z, this is equal to under root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square, clear to you? So from here you can write like this, this is Z under root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square, clear? Now what is value of R we have? That is actually what I want to say, because we are talking about resonant frequency, clear? Resonant frequency means we can say this XL is equal to XC, clear? For resonant frequency we are getting XL equal to XC, so at that time we are getting just only R square. It means I can say here resistance, this should be equal to R, clear? What is my objective? My objective here is first calculating this resonant frequency, clear? So resonant frequency omega r, this is given by we can see under root of LC. Now you can see from where we are getting this value. So you know, you already told me, sir, XL equal to XC, clear? XL is given by this is omega L, and we can say this is equal to omega C, clear? So from here you can write like this, omega square, this is equal to 1 upon LC, clear? So omega we can say this is equal to 1 upon under root of LC. So actually this omega is what? This is resonant frequency, clear? So now concentrate, now we are going to put here all values, clear? Yes. Now you can say we know here formula of resonant frequency. Resonant frequency this is given by 1 upon under root of LC, clear? Now what is value of L? We have 2, and what about C? That is 32 microfarad. So we can write like this, 1 upon under root of, I can say this is 2 multiply C, I can say this is 32 into 10 to the power minus 6, clear? So from here we can write like this, omega r is given by 1 upon under root of 64 into 10 to the power minus 6, clear? So I can say this can be written like this, this is 10 to the power 3 divided by, I can say that is 8, clear? So from here you can see resonant frequency, this is given by 125 radian per second, clear to everyone? Now Next objective here in this question is to calculate value of Q value. So Q value is actually given by one formula, omega R L by R. Clear? Omega R L by R. Clear? So from where we are getting, there is a derivation behind this expression. You can go through with NCERT as well. You can go through with any reference. Clear? So Q is given by omega R L by R. Omega R. Omega R we have, this is 125 multiply L by R. L is given to you. Yes, this is equal to 2 Henry and divided by value of R. R value we are getting, this is 10. Clear? So we can say this is 250. 250 divided by 10, this is equal to 25. Clear? Yes or no? So we are getting here this Q value. Now you can say, sir, what this Q value indicate? Actually, this Q value indicate the sharpness of a curve, because at resonance frequency we are getting maximum voltage. Clear? So actually we can say, if you find here that Q value actually indicates sharpness of a curve. Clear? So this is all about this question. Clear?